I got a guy who's got a buddy who has a ton of Corvettes. 60s, 70s Corvettes. I mean, he said he went in the guy's backyard and it was just piles. Corvette, Corvette, Corvette. This guy, he's like a Corvette freak.
His name's Craig. He's got a girlfriend. He's a postal worker, which is so bizarre because if he's sitting on a backyard full of Corvettes, it could be worth $500,000. Easy.
All right.
Don't look like a hoarder's house.
Is it the right place?
283. That's it.
You gotta be kidding me right now.
This is it? Oh, this is crazy.
Wow. This guy's got issues. Jesus.
This is a junkyard in a neighborhood. I mean, it's like house, 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 junkyard.
It is weird that the backyard over there is green, that one's green, they're all manicured, yeah. And then there's this. Then it hits me. They look like all Corvairs.
I could have swore this guy told me they were Corvettes.
It is not Corvettes. It's Corvairs. Corvairs. These all suck. This is terrible. What are we gonna do with this? I mean, there's nothing to lend any imagination with anything back here. You really wanna do this?
I'll tell you what, let's just take a look, at least.
All right. Well, he's got enough engine blocks.
Wow.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He's got 10 engines right here. Another 10, 12 over there. 50 engine blocks is crazy. And they ain't worth anything.
It's an addiction.
Yeah.
Watch out for snakes, man.
Ah! You know what? I think we're stirring up a beehive. Just seen three of them.
Yeah, they're coming out of there. It's a hornet right there.
Okay. That's a sign. That's a sign to get the hell out of here.
He wanted to turn around and walk back out.
It's all junk. And on top of that, they're Corvairs.
So I kind of had to snatch him and convince him, let's hang around for a minute.
He does have some cars here.
Once I get him going, he starts thinking in that mind of his, he'll fall in love with it.
This car's not bad.
He'll customize it, and everybody will be happy.
Look at this.
A Corvair van. You never see these.
You got your girl right here.
It's kind of cool, isn't it?
It's a classic.
Another van. This would be great for parts.
Oops. I think we might have lost 50 bucks. This is a clean car. I mean, it's a convertible. This car's worth a couple bucks. We'll flip it, take the money from this, sell the rest of this crap, scrap what we have to scrap, take the parts we need, put the money and parts into that van.
GM only made about 6,000 of these vans in 1964. So who knows how many are left in the world now?
Yeah, I don't know, man.
We could turn this thing into a surf van that would turn heads up and down the coast.
I feel like I'd be taking two steps backwards doing one of these cars. You know, everybody's got their own idea of what looks cool. I'm just saying.
I know I can convince them, but we're out of time. Because here comes Craig, the hoarder himself.
Craig.
Guys.
How you doing?
Chuck.
Chuck.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Rick.
How you doing, Rick? Thanks.
He sounds like a nice guy, but the engine blocks, the bumpers, the glass, the tires, something's wrong here. We've been surveying the property.
Have you?
What's the big deal with Corvairs?
My dad had them. It's my earliest memory of driving in a car.
My father had a Corvair station wagon, and I just remember long periods of driving in it. My dad was following work, and we were moving from one side of the country to the other, thousands of miles.
This is what happened.
Wow, this hoarder thing could be weirder than I thought.
Craig is obsessed with junk.
If we could do something with this pile of crap that's back here, I think we're really gonna be onto something. Okay, Craig, we got a proposal for you. What we do is we come into people at Hoard Cars and we offer to do one specific car for them and you give up the rest to us.
Let me ask you this, the van. We can do the van for you, make something trick and cool. Would you be happy with the van?
I love it.
Okay.
I guess we're doing the van.
Can we clear this place out? Sell what we can sell. What we can't sell, we can scrap.
But we're gonna have to flip a couple of these cars. Most of the cash is gonna come from this blue convertible and that body that's right next to your camper van that's really straight.
You know, I'm intrigued by them saying, I'm gonna fix you up one real nice one. That would be very nice. And they seem like they're honest car guys. But I don't know about giving them all of it. I don't like that.
Honestly, my girlfriend, I was thinking about proposing to her in this car. I don't know if I can let this one go.
How long you been with her?
10 years.
How long has it been sitting here like this?
Over 3 years.
3 years? You think she's gonna even notice this car gone? Now this Hoard makes total sense to me. He hangs on to everything because he can't commit to anything.
So you think all this stuff, the value is just to fix the van?
Well, the balance is gonna go in our pockets. There's gotta be something there.
Help us so we can help you.
I think there's lots of valuable stuff here.
Come on, man.
Here's the problem. It costs money to clean this up. It doesn't magically just disappear. It costs money to build a van.
I think maybe there's enough other stuff. This one, I bought it for her on Valentine's Day. And it is one of the more valued vehicles back here.
And,
I think
and that's why we need it.
I do like my cars. I mean, this is an accumulation of 20 years of cars.
We are not gonna be able to do this unless you go with the program, and that involves getting rid of this one and that one.
All right, look. Let's forget about this car for a little while. Let us clear the place out the best we can. We'll start scrapping, we'll start selling, then let's see where we're at.
I don't know what Chuck's thinking. Money is gonna be so tight without that convertible.
How often do you find a hoard of cars? It's not like we have one on every street corner. So I'm making the deal. As long as Craig's willing to sell that convertible, if we need the money to finish the van. Maybe we can talk about it again later.
Keep an open mind with the blue one. Do we have a deal?
Okay?
All right. I'm gonna hold you to it.
Okay, Rick.
And just like that, we're on our way.
Watch those. This one's going on your two-car trailer. Do some demolition, kid.
So I call my buddy Will.
My name is William Clark Coit III.
He's the cleaner.
Transportation coordinator.
Down left hard.
Normally, I'm moving maybe a half dozen cars on a trailer. So when I walked into this yard, it was like, whoa.
Straight there.
We got 25 cars, no runners, bumpers, doors, 50 engine blocks. About 10,000 pounds of metal jammed into a half an acre.
Squirrel!
This place is like a bomb went off. Craig running around like he doesn't know where to go. Do I save this? Do I keep that? Do I sell that? You ask him if he has something. Oh, no, I don't have that. 2 minutes later, I find something hidden under a tarp. Craig's a typical hoarder.
Well, you got a lot of parts in here.
Well, you never know when you're gonna find it and need it.
Throw it on the two car.
And in the middle of all this chaos, there's Joe.
Joe the Hat. Rick Dorr gave me a call, and he knows I'm the best at what I do at selling cars.
Piece of shit.
But if we're gonna make any money, Joe the Hat has to do some hustling.
Parts, cars, shells, bodies. These Corvairs just don't bring a lot of money.
Watch back.
I think once we lump all this stuff together, I can probably make something out of it. But it's gonna be a grind.
Let's get these things up online. Boom, import.
Yeah. I'm excited to do a Corvair van. I think they're cool, I think they're hip.
For me, it's a zero. It's just the whole Corvair thing. With my reputation, American cars, vintage cars, I don't want to get a bum wire out there on me that,
Rick.
Jesus Christ, what happened to Rick Dorr?
Rick, are you good at what you do?
I think I am.
I think I'm good at what I do. What about maybe we challenge ourselves and make something cool? I think we can do it. Design it how you would like. I'll worry about the money. Let's just do it.
All right. This is really a big decision for us to do this, the risk of the money, the risk of our reputation. But if Chuck says it's gonna be good, I'll trust Chuck.